Starr has been a goodwill ambassador for motorcycling most of his life. His work in the entertainment industry as a TV producer, filmmaker, and stuntman includes more than 50 specials and feature films about motorcycling. Born in Coventry, England, Starr started riding motorcycles at an early age. He raced Ariels, Nortons, and Triumphs, and turned his love for bikes into a job working for Triumph in the early 1960s. After moving to the United States, Starr spent 6 years as a rock and roll DJ and 2 years as a record producer before turning back to motorcycles as a filmmaker. His first film, Bad Rock, was about the ISDE qualifier in Oregon in 1973. But the film for which Starr is best known is Take It to the Limit. The thrill-packed adventure covers every aspect of motorcycling and features some of the greatest riders of all time. In Take It to the Limit, we see Kenny Roberts win the mile on the TZ750 two-stroke, then later begin his quest for 3 road racing world championships. We watch Roger DeCoster at the height of his career on his way to 5 motocross world championships. Bruce Penhall rides to Speedway glory, and Mike Hailwood returns to the Isle of Man. It is truly one of the greatest films about motorcycling ever made. Take It to the Limit won gold and silver awards at the Chicago and Houston International Film Festivals in 1980 and introduced a love of motorcycling to millions around the world. Many firsts that incorporated motorcycling into entertainment were introduced by Peter Starr. Among his groundbreaking innovations are the first film camera mounted on a motorcycle during an AMA National at Laguna Seca in 1980, the first live broadcast from a motorcycle in competition at an AMA National at the DuQuoin Mile for ABC's Wide World of Sports in 1985. He created the first national television series about motorcycling in 1981, the Peter Starr Motorcycle Show for the Nashville Network. Starr also brought Stroh's sponsorship to the Dirt Track series and created the Stroh Miles in 1984 and 85, which were broadcast on the Nashville Network and USA Network. He designed and built the first fully functional motorcycle sidecar camera vehicles for use in major movies, including Batman and Robin, Apollo 13, and Lethal Weapon 3. Today, Peter Starr still rides, writes, produces, and directs with a focus on motorcycles. He encourages others to ride through programs like the Grand Riders, which promotes seniors to continue their passion for living through motorcycle riding. For his lifetime of substantial contributions to motorcycling, which includes more than 50 specials and feature films about motorcycling, and his continuing work in the industry, the AMA proudly welcomes Peter Starr to the AMA Motorcycle Hall of Fame.